peace agreement between Imam Hassan and Muawiyah. Imam Hassan alayhi salam faced extremely difficult conditions from the start. He observed that fear, anxiety, and much distress were ever present in Kufa, Basra, Medina, and other towns. The anxiety, uncertainty, and insecurity were caused by Muawiyah's ill dealings of sincere Muslims. Muawiyah had spread secret agents all over to defame Ahlul Bayt. Imam Hassan knew that his father, Imam Ali alayhi salam, had stood like a lion in all difficulties and fought battles against Muawiyah. But these confrontations had resulted in heavy casualties on both sides. A mass-scale family devastation was visible everywhere. Considering all circumstances, Imam Hassan alayhi salam discussed the matter with his brother Hussein alayhi salam and other relatives. He revealed to them that in order to end the bloodshed and to provide a reasonable safety and security to the Ummah, he would make peace agreement with Muawiyah and abdicate until after Muawiyah's death. After a few days of careful consideration, Imam Hassan alayhi salam accepted an agreement as per the terms dictated by the Imam and agreed to by Muawiyah. Four noteworthy terms of this agreement were: people of Syria, Iraq, Hejaz, Yemen, and other places shall enjoy amnesty against persecution. Friends and companions of Imam Ali alayhi salam and all their women and children shall be protected from all dangers. Muawiyah is to immediately stop the use of abusive language with reference to Ahlul Bayt, cursing Imam Ali after Salatul Jum'ah, and Muawiyah shall not appoint anyone as his successor. Once the treaty was signed, Imam Hassan alayhi salam and brother Hussein moved out of Kufa and settled in Medina. Over there, both Imams lost no time in holding nightly meetings for Islamic discussions, and the nightly meetings proved very successful and gained tremendous popularity. More people started to attend to hear the Imams give of their fountain of knowledge on Islam and humanity. The reputation of these meetings began to fly to faraway places, and people from as far away as Egypt, Iraq, Yemen, and other distant areas traveled to Medina to learn about the Islamic values. In the meantime, Muawiyah unabashedly elected to disregard the terms of his treaty with Imam al-Hassan. He sent secret agents to terrorize, kidnap, or even kill innocent people, especially those who were loyal to Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam. Instead of helping the needy with the public treasury, Muawiyah's governors and their surrogates used the public treasury for personal use, freely and excessively as they wished. Freedom suddenly died and a dictatorship took its place. Muawiyah gathered a very large number of collaborators who unabashedly would do anything for money.